This is the last example that I'm going to do on my ZeroGecko board. I'm having this process run in sleep mode until I wake it up from an external event. And that external event is an interrupt when I click this button. So it will be in energy mode 3, which is almost deep sleep. When I click this button, an external GPIO event will fire up, wake up the processor, and as long as I keep the button down, it will do some GPIO exercises. What it actually does is it reads the status of this buffer. And as long as that status is down, it will keep doing that. When I release the button, it will go back to sleep mode. And that's what I'm going to measure on the profiler.
So I have the code here. I'll now open the program in profiler mode. And you will see that it is running in very low energy mode. So now I will push that button, keep it down, and it's going to normal energy mode. I'll release the button, and we're back to low energy mode. So that's how you see how this processor handles the energy modes. So in sleep, it's 420-430 nanoamps, consuming 1.5 microwatt. In full active mode, it's 1.8 milliamps, consuming 5.8 milliwatt.
Hey, and that's it. That concludes my road test. I wanted to investigate how well the ZeroGecko is fitted for low power execution, and also how good the starter kit was and the software pack that comes with it. And I'm quite impressed. No doubt the EFM32 microcontroller is very low power and has sufficient energy modes to make it run on battery for a long time, if you do it the right way and if you use it in the right way. So I'd use this microcontroller in those situations where you can sleep a lot, but where you have to wake up fast and then need sufficient calculation power. So I think that that's the sweet spot of this processor.